Josh, today we are talking about the Central Vista project, and you have some great insights to share with us. Now, the first thing that everybody is saying, anybody who's opposed to the project is saying, is that we are living through a pandemic, and this project is supposed to be at an estimated cost of $2.7 billion. Now, just because some Indian politicians need to have a little extra leg space, is it actually worth spending so much money?
Yeah, no, that's a great way to phrase it. But I think what the critics miss often is that it's a little bit more than a little extra legroom. What is really happening with this project is that the way governance is conducted is being reimagined. Now, I don't want to throw a lot of long words and jargon at you or our dear viewers. So let me break that down. Let me give you three words, right? Delimitation. Let me give you the second word, which is earthquakes. And the third word is productivity. Okay, delimitation is when we match the number of people in the country with the representatives. Now, when we all know that the Indian population has exploded in the last 75 years, right? But the size of the parliamentary house remains the same. That means that the number of our representatives can't go up significantly, but the number of the people in the country has been shooting up astronomically. We had one MP every 7 million people, at the start of our journey at independence. And now we have one MP every 22 million people. So what happens when one MP is representing so many millions of people is that perverse incentives start to climb up atop one another. So if one person is representing so many different people, there's no good way in which he, because the interests of half the people or of a quarter of the people will be very different from the other 5 million people in the same state or in the same part of the country. And so we need more representatives, and that is delimitation. And that can only happen once we expand the size of our parliamentary house. Now, some people say, oh, it just expands sitting in the old house. It's not possible. It's just structurally not possible. The current house can only have 550 members or thereabouts. And the new house, which is being constructed, can have 888 members. So we are good for the next few decades, perhaps even the next two centuries. And it can be expanded up to 1,200 members for joint sessions. So that's the first reason, the delimitation. The second thing I said was earthquakes. Delhi is in a seismic 4 zone. The current parliamentary building is constructed to withstand shocks that happen in seismic 3 zones. To put it more simply, Delhi can expect earthquakes that may well bring down the parliamentary house. Now, that is the center of power. It is the seat of the Indian government. Are we comfortable with that level of natural vulnerability? I'm not. I want a seismic 4 level building where the seat of our government can be properly established. So we need to take that into account as well. The third thing I said, right? The third thing I told you was that when you're discussing this issue, one thing that people don't mention as often is productivity, right? The work that we do, and this is something we have all realized in the era of work from home, is that the work we do is very often dependent on the workplace. Like, we take so much effort and we put so much sweat into improving our workplaces and our desk and making sure everything's right. The current workplace of our ministers, the 51 ministries across Delhi, first of all, they are all separated from each other. So much of government work cannot be put online due to classified reasons, right? Due to you want the secrets of the government in some cases to stay on paper, right? You don't want some hacker to get access to it. But because of all these ministries are so far apart from each other, their communication is very slow. Right. So what the new plan is doing is it's putting all of these 51 ministries in close geometric proximity to each other so that their work experience, their workflow, their productivity increases. And so these are great reasons to redo our parliamentary house and the surrounding Central Vista area. Yeah.
Please remember to subscribe to us and switch on the notifications for this channel. For our other social media links, more content, and to support our work, please visit citti.net. Dhanyavaad. Namaskar.